Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Stone Shard. As always, I am Dorne. Today, we're going to go ahead and loot up the dungeon from last episode. So I managed to go ahead and kill the Necromancer. He's right there on the ground. And the other guy managed to chase us all the way back over here. This is where I managed to kill him at. And we almost died again trying to clear this, but he was literally the last guy we ended up trading with, and then we ended up coming back and clearing the dungeon here. So right now, we only have 4 lockpicks to go ahead and open all these chests. I don't know if we're going to need them for the sarcophaguses or not. It doesn't look like we do. And they just have some gold and skeletons in them. I'm going to go ahead and take the cups for right now. I'm not going to bother with the skeletons because there's no point to taking them right now that I've seen. So I'm not going to waste the inventory space on them. But we're going to go ahead and take what we can that's worth value. And then we're going to go ahead and pick open these chests. If we end up breaking our picks, I don't know if we're able to attack the chest. I don't think we'll be able to. That doesn't really make a whole lot of sense if we are, but if we can, that's great. If not, then it is what it is. We also didn't get lucky with the stuff this guy dropped. So last time he dropped an enchanted staff thing, which he didn't drop this time, but he did drop a reinforced one that we can sell for 251 gold. So for right now, we'll go ahead and hold on to it until we don't need it anymore. I don't have my potion thing on me, but we have identification scrolls now, so that's great. We're also going to go ahead and change out our ring really quick, because that ring right there is a little bit better than the one that we had on. We won't get rid of it. We might end up getting rid of it, actually. It's only 18 gold. It's not that big of a deal. So let me wander on over to the next little thing of loot, which I think is going to be the guy in that room. Is there a chest over here? We have a bunch of sarcophaguses over here, so let's actually walk over there and loot those things as well. So we got an empty one there. What do we got in this one? We got a little bit of gold in there. We have 400 gold left over. I bought some food. That's why we have a little bit less gold than last episode. I bought another water thing, and I bought a thing of food, and that's where some of our money went, so that's why we're kind of down again. But nonetheless, we can hopefully make it all back by the loot that's going to be in here, which doesn't seem to be all that great right now. And yeah, we have another empty one and another empty one. Okay, so I'm not going to worry about breaking the containers because we can do that as well, but that's not always a guarantee that it's going to drop something. So I don't really want to use the durability up on our swords and stuff right now. So I'm just going to go ahead and leave them alone from here on out because it doesn't really seem to be that great of an idea to go ahead and use our sword to be doing it. It doesn't take that much durability off our sword, but I'd rather not use the durability to break little pots and stuff that aren't going to give us stuff every time. We also might have enough of these swords and cleavers on the ground to go ahead and complete the other guy's quest as well. So we have one of those, and then we have one of the falcons in our chest back at the bar. So as long as we can go ahead and find the other ones in this place as well, we can go ahead and complete that quest today. Okay, there we go. We finally found another item in one of these sarcophaguses. So we have an unidentified ring, which we can actually burn one of these things on right now just to see if it's going to be better than one of the ones we have on. And it has a curse on it, so we might not want to use that. It has a 16% life drain on it. The move resistance and energy restoration, skill energy cost, experience gain. Ooh, we get a bonus on XP, but I'm not sure if the life drain that's on there is worth the experience gain that we get from it. So I'm not going to go ahead and put that on our character at the moment because I'd really rather not die just by putting that on, so I'm going to leave it alone. And we don't have any of the swords in this little grouping of items, so I'm going to ignore all the stuff on the ground because we're kind of limited on space at the moment. We got some more gold, and we got a staff in the other one, although it's only worth 8 gold, and we don't have the room for it at the moment, so that can go ahead and hang out there. We finally found another chest here. Let's go ahead and open that up and see what we got. We got some gold. We got another one of these things. I'm going to go ahead and actually sell these when I get back to the town because they don't really give us any health. They just take away pain, and they give us some morale here, but we don't really have anything magic related right now, which is the boost and stuff that it gives us, so I don't really need these in my inventory taking up space. So I'm going to go ahead and probably end up selling these. They sell for 300 a piece, apparently. I don't think that's actually what we're going to get for those, but we have those available if we need to. So this one sells for 251, and then the axe sells for 253. Okay, well, we don't have space for it nonetheless. I'm going to go ahead and leave that in the chest. Ooh, we have another chest right here next to it. Sweet, I didn't realize that. We got some more gold, and we got a bottle of wine. So let's go ahead and take that with us for right now. We're probably going to end up dropping that because we, again, are very limited on space. And that's the end of this little run here. Most of the sarcophaguses so far have been empty. So it's just a bunch of bones and stuff. I don't know if I should be taking the bones because they don't really sell for a whole lot, but I don't know if the bone dust stuff that you can grind them into sells for a decent amount or not. It's probably just some sort of a potion mix or something that we use that for, so I don't really mind it too much at the moment. But we have another chest over in this room, and we also have an enchanted spear, which I'm gonna guess is probably gonna be like this big, so let me drop that for right now and grab that. And yeah, it takes up the entire slot there. So let me see if I can wiggle some stuff around and maybe, oh, we can't pick that back up, right? That was a 2x3. So, or yeah, 2x3, we can't actually pick that back up even if we rearrange some stuff here. So let's just go ahead and loot the chest. Oh, we failed to pick. And what do we got? We got gold and some antlers, so I'm not gonna take the antlers. Well, actually, why not? We can clear the room here, and we can go and squeeze those in. Let's see if we got anything in there. We don't. Do we have anything in this one? We do not. Okay. So we have a couple more of these sarcophaguses to go through, and I think most of these are gonna be just the skull and bone stuff. I don't think there's gonna be anything actually in them other than gold every now and again, which is great. We don't need that sword. That's not one of the ones we need, so I'm not gonna bother with it. And what do we have here? We have some more gold, and that's the entire floor cleared. So now we get to go ahead and move upstairs and clear the entire floor up there as well. There's gonna be, I think, another 2 chests, I think, up there. Maybe 3 chests, I'm not quite sure. But we have a whole ton of the sarcophaguses up here as well, so I'm gonna go ahead and loot through all of those. I actually killed myself on this trap while I was trying to clear this dungeon again. I didn't realize it. I thought it didn't do that much damage because when I tried to disarm the other one, it didn't do that much damage. It burned us for like 1 turn. But stepping on the thing actually does a ton of damage, and then it burns you for like 3 or 4 turns, which isn't great. And so I ended up just burning to death after clearing this whole floor. And I was about to go downstairs to clear the rest of it, and then I stepped on that, and it was not a fun time. So we don't have anything right here. Where are the stuff up here? I think we have stuff this way. We do indeed. Okay. I think this place is going to be just like the other one. As soon as we leave and turn in the quest, I think it's going to break the entrance to it so that we can't come back down here. I could be wrong, but I think that's probably what's going to happen as well here. But so far, we don't have the swords and stuff. I thought I had a falcon up here somewhere, which we might. I'm just not seeing it at the moment. We have another chest right here. We have 2 more chests in this room. Sweet. We got some gold. We got one of these things as well, which we don't have the room. Oh, we do have the room for that. Never mind. We have some boots, which are a little bit better on durability than the ones we have. But they don't have the enchants on them. And let's see, we also have a crossbow that's enchanted. Now, we don't have any range setup, right? We don't have any arrows and stuff in our inventory, so I don't think we're ever going to really use that, but we can go ahead and sell it. So let me go ahead and wiggle some stuff around here. We don't need the antlers. We can probably just drop these things off, although they sell for 300. And we have to waste this thing on it to see how much this is going to sell for. We also have an enchanted ring, which I'm going to go ahead and use the scroll on that instead so that we can maybe swap out one of these rings, which we're probably going to do right now. Yeah, we'll go ahead and swap that out for the normal little silver ring that we had on. So then we can go ahead and put our rings over there. And let's see, I'm going to play some rearranging thing here to go ahead and try and squeeze that crossbow in. We're not going to take the cup. There's no point in that. So let's see, maybe we can go ahead and cram that in. What is it, a 3x2 little thing as well? All right, there we go. We got enough room now. I ate the salami thing that we had. So now we have the crossbow. I don't think we're going to take the boots. They're only worth 54 gold, and they only have, 15 more durability than the ones we have on. Plus, they don't have the enchantment on them. They do have a couple more little stats, but I'm not gonna worry about taking those, to be honest. So let's go ahead and loot this chest as well if we can. Oh, that's 2 fails in a row there. How many more of these do we have? We have no more lockpicks, apparently. That's great. And we can apparently go ahead and attack the chest. So does that open it immediately? That did not open it. Can we attack it again? Is that gonna open it eventually, or are we just gonna end up breaking the chest? We broke the chest. And it doesn't look like anything fell out of the chest either. So we might have just burned whatever loot that was actually in that chest. So that's not a good thing. So really quickly here, I'm just going to go ahead and loot the sarcophaguses then, because we don't have any more lockpicks. I'm going to guess that we're going to lose whatever loot's in these things, since the door to this place might close behind us when we leave. But hopefully we can go ahead and find some sort of hopefully we can find something else in these sarcophaguses is to go ahead and maybe open up stuff. That's another one of the things we don't need. We don't have anything in that one. Do we have anything in here? No, we do not. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and leave. I think there's a couple more things to loot over here. Oh, no, that's the exit. Okay, no, we're done completely with it then. We only lost out on loot from one chest because our lockpick broke. So it's not that big of a deal, I don't think. We have some stuff we can go ahead and sell now, which is going to be great. And we might also hit the 1,000 buck thing for the other mission as well right now. I'm going to go ahead and wander back to the town, hopefully. So we can go ahead and give this guy the Grimoire here. So let's go ahead and turn in that contract. Let's go ahead and give him that. Get that. And we got a bunch of gold from that. So we got 505 gold, I believe, was the contract asking price. So now we can go outside and sell the rest of this stuff to all of the little merchants out here. We're going to go ahead and sell pretty much everything in our inventory except for the meds, I believe, if we can. So let's go ahead and talk to this guy. So we can't actually sell these items because they're still considered unidentified and we can't sell them unless we buy one of these and then use it on it and then sell it to him. So let's go ahead and buy this from him and then we can go ahead and use it on, let's go with the crossbow. I feel like the crossbow is going to sell for better because it's enchanted and it's blue. Actually, it's only selling for 17. Okay, well, that's a bit of a not good. And we can go ahead and sell him the jade figurine. He has 600 gold available, so let's also sell him the beers and let's sell him these things. They only sell for 90 out of the 300 that they suggest they can sell for, and I don't think he has enough gold for anything else, so we can sell the copper ring for 11 gold. Let's go and do that. We can sell him the cursed one for 60, which he doesn't have anymore. 260. Do we have anything else we can sell him? 76. No, right now we're going to go ahead and move on over to another merchant and then sell the rest of the stuff to them. So let's go ahead and do that. We can also read this book. I didn't realize it, but this is going to go ahead and give us some of the skills to go ahead and learn. So let's go ahead and read that. It's going to unlock a bunch of stuff. And now when we go into our skills here, we can go ahead and see those skills. So I think it was staffs, right? Yeah, we don't have the very first tier of stuff unlocked, but that just unlocked the second tier of stuff. So we still need to go ahead and discover another book to learn those skills with the staff, but when we do, we have the second tier already unlocked, so we can go ahead and progress down the tree if we wanted to. That's kind of why we can't go down the tree on the swords here. We need to go ahead and find books or whatever it is that's going to unlock the second tier for us so we can go ahead and progress down the tree a little bit, but that's pretty much all we can do right now. So let's go ahead and wait until the rest of the workers show up, which I guess that's it right there. Can we sell you the rest of this stuff? We can sell her the cursed ring. So that's 60 gold in our pocket. We can sell her the other one as well for 82 gold. And now we just need to go ahead and find someone who wants to buy those two gems from us because we can't really use it anymore. So I'm going to try the blacksmith over here and we can go ahead and sell them to him. That's great. We're up to 1900 gold, which is sweet. We need to actually repair some of our gear. The bracers that we have on are only 19 out of 50 durability left on them, and they're also kind of banged up a little bit, so let's go ahead and repair some of our stuff. We actually have to go to the other guy for the leather bracers, not this guy. Okay, but we can go ahead and fix our sword at least, and we can fix our pendant. We don't really need to, though, so I'm not going to do that. And we should be good with the stuff that we have here. We need to find if we can sell the book to anybody. I don't know if we can, but if we could, that's great. I'm going to go to the other guy that should be right here, right? The leather or the lumber guy? He's right over here. Okay, I think he's the guy we need to go ahead and talk to go ahead and fix our shield and the bracers, I believe. No, I still can't fix the bracers with this guy, but I can fix my shield, which really needs it because it was really banged up there. Okay, so does this guy have a better shield? I probably should have looked at that before I fix that one. Not really. So let's go ahead and find the person we need for the bracers. I'm going to try this person. I don't know what they actually sell. I think he's also a weapon guy. Oh, he's the tailorer. Okay, so yeah, he's the guy we need to go ahead and talk to. So we need to go ahead and fix our bracers. Do we need to fix our chest piece? We kind of do. Not really, though. Same thing with our hood. Do we have a better hood available from this guy? We can go ahead and change out our hood for this hat because it has a +1 protection and a +2% for physical resistance. So that's better than nothing that's currently on our hat. So let's go ahead and do that. And then we can sell him the old one if we want, just to go ahead and get a little bit of cash out of it, which isn't a whole lot. He doesn't have any boots. He does not have any boots. Okay, so that's all we need from this guy. We fixed our stuff, and we got a new hat. Let me see if maybe the herbalist guy wants to buy that book. I don't know who wants to buy that book. Maybe we can't sell it at all, and we just have to go and shove it in a chest or something. So this guy also doesn't want the booklet, so maybe we can't sell this. But I'm wondering if we could have sold the herbalist here the little packets of stardust, and maybe got got a better price for. I don't know if the game's that specific, like if the herbalist is going to give us better prices for medical stuff versus just a random merchant out on the street. I don't know if it's like that or not, but we could have probably tried that. I totally forgot about the herbalist back down here, but let me go ahead and dump some stuff off in our chest really quick, and then we can go ahead and talk with the main character guy, and he's going to go ahead and take us to the new town here because we have, I think, 1,600 gold or something like that right now. All right, let's go ahead and give Varen his 1,000 bucks, and then we can go ahead and travel on to Bryn to go ahead and see what that town is going to be like. So it's just south of the other town that we went to, Manshire. So now we are here, and it looks like it's an actual town thing going on here. So that's kind of cool. Let's go ahead and see if we can find the main dude, which is going to be the guy that we need to go ahead and get quests and stuff from. We also still have the other quest to go ahead and turn in for the other, although one just disappeared. I think we had 4 of these, right? We had the smith one to bring him the 3 swords. We had the bear pelt and the bison pelt. Oh, we also had the herbalist one. Okay, yeah, we completed that one already. Never mind. There we go. Now we're actually in Bryn. We weren't actually in it a second ago. We were out of the tile here at the stables and stuff, so that's why we weren't actually able to find anybody. So let's see if we can go ahead and find the main person. Okay, maybe I'm not supposed to be here yet, because every door I try to go into, it's red, which means we're gonna break into the place and get in trouble with the guards. So I don't know if we are supposed to be here exactly. I can't seem to find the bar to go ahead and interact with the bartender who's gonna tell me where the main guy is. I can interact with the shopkeeps and stuff right here. That's not an issue, but they're not the main guy who's going to tell us where we need to go ahead and do any missions. But this guy has some cool stuff. Ooh, that's kind of cool. That also is, oh, that's way, way out of our price range at the moment. Never mind. That's also way out of our price range. Woof. Yeah, we can't afford anything this guy is selling. It's all like 2,600 bucks or more, which is way, way out of our price range. And he's also selling the identification scrolls more expensive than the other guy. The other guy's selling them, I think, for 91 gold. This guy's selling them for 131 gold, which I'm not going to pay. So I think for right now, what I'm going to go ahead and do is walk around the town a little bit more and see if I can find the bar. I can't seem to find it anywhere. I thought this was going to be the bar right here, but I can't go in that door either. So I'm not sure if this town has a bar. I feel like it should have one. And then this place as well. It has a little scale thing, which I thought is a store, but I can't go in there either. So I feel like I need to talk to somebody about interacting with stuff here, but I just can't seem to find who that is. I don't have a quest or anything for this town, and the guy on the wagon didn't exactly tell me anything that I needed to do. He might have, honestly. I probably just skipped over it. Okay, so I think I found the tavern. I mean, I don't know what else this icon could mean. It looks like a little beer mug, but we are right here in this part of the town now. It's 4 tiles big. I didn't realize how big the town was, but the door is still red, so we can't actually go in there, and I don't know what door we're supposed to go into. I found one door so far, and we are apparently being stopped by the guard because he thinks we're a thief, but we're not a thief at the moment, so I don't really mind him stopping us. And there also doesn't seem to be people working the little shops and stuff that are out and about. Maybe we're too late in the day here for them to be out and about working, which is probably what's happening. Maybe all the shops are closed for the time of day, and they're not actually, like, locked behind stuff. Because right now, all I'm seeing mostly on the streets are guards. There was one shop that we were actually able to go into, and that was a food shop, and we couldn't ask the guy any questions. We just could either buy food or just leave and ask him how his business is going. So I'm not too sure what we do here. We don't have a quest or anything still, right? Yeah, we don't have any quest or anything that popped up. So I'm going to go ahead and try and uncover as much of the area here as I can to see maybe there's a building or something we need to go into and, like, get permission to be here from, like, the main city guy. I'm not quite sure here. Okay, so I found the guy. He's just standing out in the first little part of the town that we went to. I walked right past him, like, once or twice because I just thought he was a normal guard. But he's apparently the right guy. He's the Grand Magistrate. Unless I'm remembering that wrong, that should be the town, like, mayor guy that is in control of all the stuff. But if we go ahead and click on him to go ahead and talk with him, he just tells us to go ahead and get lost. So I don't know if we are supposed to be here. I don't know if there's another quest or something that we're missing to unlock this area properly or something. I'm not too sure. But I'm going to go ahead and head back to the other town because we still have some more quests we can go ahead and do for the little merchants and stuff that are over there. And then hopefully we can go ahead and complete some of those. So I actually think that's going to go ahead and be it for today's episode. Next episode, we're going to go ahead and hopefully complete one or two of those things. We don't really know where a bison or a bear is right now, so I can't really do those. And the same kind of thing with the sword. swords here. We have one of each right now. I don't know if we can mix and match with the swords here or if we need three of one or the other. But right now we only have one of them. So if we go ahead and complete that, great. If not, then it's just going to take us some time to go ahead and complete those. But I think for next episode, what we're going to go ahead and do is travel on down to one of these places because we have two areas discovered. So we can go ahead and take a look at what those are. We have the witch and then we have the leopard colony thing that was over here as well. So we're probably going to go ahead and check those things out if we don't go ahead and complete another mission for the mayor dude that's in this town. But I think for right now, that's going to go ahead and be it for today's episode. So hope you guys enjoyed as always, and I'll catch you in the next one. Thanks for watching.